Hi guys, this is David Kwan, here to talk about Resident Evil Revelations, which I played on my 3DS. I don't know if this was like if this was a good idea, because this is the very first game I played on. It's the first 3DS game I've ever played. I've never touched any other 3DS game before this. So I don't know if this was a good idea, because now I feel like I'm totally spoiled. Because the graphics on this baby are amazing. Because I imagine 3DS to be like a little more powerful than a PlayStation 2, but like much less underwhelming compared to like PS3 or anything. And because that's just me from judging, like from seeing a lot of the trailers of different 3DS games and sort of stuff of the nature. I go into Resident Evil Revelations, I'm just like, holy crap, this is what 3DS is capable of. Wow. Like that speaks volumes. The graphics are amazing. I don't know what I've been expecting of the 3DS. Maybe it was just because I had such low expectations. I don't know, but I'm totally blown away by the graphics. And the 3D effects are amazing. Like, and I've turned it up because there's a setting in this game where you can actually crank up the 3D effects more than the official Nintendo 3D effects. So I can crank it up even more. I put it to strong, not very strong because that kind of made me a little nauseous, but strong. And then it's amazing because, I've started to notice like how it uses to, the characters in the environment are separate from the environment, so that kind of sticks out and that acts as a 3D effect. And Jesus, it's amazing. It's not quite up there, but it's like an HD version of Resident Evil 4. That was like kind of what the graphics reminded me of. It looked better than Resident Evil 4 on the Wii. So I was just surprisingly pleasantly shocked by the graphics. And the only other game I've played on the 3DS so far is a demo of Sonic All-Star Racing Sega All-Stars. I don't even know the title, but you know the racing game with Sega characters that, where the carts transform into jets and boats. That game, I played the demo of that. And I played the demo of Castlevania, Lord of Shadow, Mirror of Fate. All these games with like super long titles. Played that. And then I just gamefied Splinter Cell 3D. That was an easy title. Splinter Cell 3D. And yeah, playing all those things and then playing Resident Evil Revelations, I feel like I'm totally spoiled because I still haven't seen even near like half the quality of the graphics of Resident Evil Revelations in any of the other 3DS demos or games I've played. Splinter Cell 3D was quite disappointing, especially in graphics department. I don't remember Splinter Cell Chaos Theory being not so good graphically. I remember it being like super awesome, but then playing it on my 3DS, I was totally underwhelmed. Whereas with this game, it's just like, wow, I don't know if I should be, if I'm able to play any other 3DS game expecting this level of graphics. So I feel like I'm being spoiled. And now let's get into the game and just skip the graphics talk, because obviously I have nothing but really great things to say about the graphics. The other things, you know, I think this is a great game. I went into this game reading a lot in the forums that like this is what Resident Evil 6 should have been. I haven't played Resident Evil 6, so I haven't formed my opinion yet of whether Resident Evil 6 is a great game, or a good game, or a bad game, or a horrible game to me, because I haven't played it. I'm not interested in playing that at all. I just looked at that, I'm just like, that kind of looks bad. But I haven't played it yet, so I can't really say for sure. Resident Evil Revelations, I went into it, I saw some trailers, I'm just like, that's the game I want to play. And then I played it, I'm just like, yeah. That's the game I definitely wanted to play. This game is awesome. Part of the reason is the setting is so perfect. The premise of this setting is, the plot is like all over the place as you would expect from Resident Evil game. That's the weakest element of this game, obviously. But just the setting is set on a ship. Inside the ship. And the ship is like, there's different sections of the ship where it's all metallic. The ship in the middle of the game starts to sink and it gets flooded, there's water around and it gets all dark and eerie. There's some parts of the ship where it feels like a mansion or you're in a castle. It's just a great setting. And I've realized, this is what I come to now realize, that Resident Evil belongs indoors. Once you have Resident Evil playing outdoors, it's not fun anymore. And that's pretty much what I felt when Resident Evil Revelations had me playing as different characters in like an outdoor snowy setting in a cave or whatever. It was not fun. Playing those areas was just like, oh man, I have to play these like action sequences or shooting down. Whereas indoor, like, it felt creepy, it felt eerie, the vibe was just amazing. So what I've come to realize is that like Resident Evil, except for in cases of Resident Evil 4, because that game still managed to be successful in outdoor settings. But Resident Evil, I feel like as a whole, does best when you're in an indoor claustrophobic setting. And Resident Evil Revelation, majority of the game is like that, which is pretty amazing. One of the most unique thing about Resident Evil Revelation compared to any other game in the franchise, you actually swim in it. There are underwater sections, and it's not bad. It's quite harrowing, actually. I think the two most frightening moments I've had in this game is in the beginning of the game, like beginning moments of the game where Jill has no weapons and has to go around the ship totally unarmed. That was terrifying. I love that. It's a weird device to use in a video game because it's when I'm playing that, I'm just like, I need a weapon. So I'm like desperately like wanting this part to be over. And then yet when the part is over, I look back and I'm just like, I thoroughly enjoy all the frightening scares I got not having a weapon at all. You know, it's kind of like, I think that's one of the joys of Resident Evil. It's just like when you're enjoying that experience, you kind of want to be over with that experience. But then when you're over, it's just like, that was intense. I loved it. So that was like one of my favorite moments in there. The other one was when the ship is kind of half flooded. And so you're going around and then you can't really like see the enemies underneath the waters. And these are powerful enemies. And you're just kind of going around scared for your life, not knowing when they'll pop up, where they'll pop up, and just running around scared shitless. That was awesome. There's just a lot of great ideas and a lot of great moments in this game that I really enjoyed. Obviously, like the biggest downers about Resident Evil Revelation is the campy plot. It's enjoyable though. It's not bad. It's not Resident Evil 5 bad. Oh my gosh, I couldn't stand that whole premise of that game or the voice acting or the characters. Where Resident Evil Revelation, I really enjoyed it. It's the worst part about the game, but at the same time, it's the weakest part of the game. But at the same time, it's kind of enjoyable. Like I've always I kind of played it like, oh, I wonder where this is gonna go, or how Chris and Jill eventually meet up, how that's gonna happen and stuff like that. And even the action sequences are not too bad. I agree with people who say the enemies in Resident Evil Revelations are just no longer as fun as fighting like just creepily, you know, slow hordes of zombies. Zombies are definitely more fun than these weird creatures like thingies, but you know, I thoroughly really enjoyed Resident Evil Revelations, and I know there's now being the HD versions made for the PS3, 360, and I think the PC version is also being made too. I'm not sure about the Wii U version, I don't know, but I'm excited to replay it again in HD version whenever that happens. I think whenever I end up getting my PS3 repaired, shit, I'm totally excited to play Resident Evil Revelations again in HD on harder difficulty. That would be a lot of fun.